Good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We are following a developing story out of Spofford, where crews are on the scene of a house fire. The flames broke out at a home on Rosewood Lane a little after 4 a.m. Dispatchers tell us there were people home when the fire started, but at this time, there are no reports of any injuries. We do have a crew there at the scene. They'll bring you an update as soon as we get more information here on our website. Four men serving life in prison for first-degree murder will get new sentencing hearings because of a Supreme Court decision about giving life sentences to juveniles. Robert Dingman, Eduardo Lopez, Michael Soto, and Robert Tulloch were all teenagers when they committed their crimes and all received automatic life sentences. The U.S. Supreme Court, though, has ruled that mandatory life sentences for juveniles is unconstitutional. A suspect in an armed robbery in Plastow is accused of hitting a police cruiser two times while trying to get away. Sunday afternoon, police say a man armed with a handgun robbed the Rite Aid pharmacy on Garden Road, making off with some pills. An officer responding to the scene tried to pull over the suspect's car, but the driver refused to stop. Police say the suspect hit the officer's cruiser two times in an attempt to get away. Now, that driver, 37-year-old Jason Gaff of Hampstead, was eventually arrested on several charges, including robbery. He's now being held on $50,000 bail. Shaw's grocery chain plans to close six stores in New Hampshire. It will close its stores in Seabrook, Goffstown, Manchester, Tilton, Keene, and on Plainfield Road in West Lebanon. Shaw's and Star Market says those stores stopped turning profits a while ago, and efforts to turn that around have not worked. A long-awaited honor for a Navy veteran from Pelham. Senator Kelly Ayotte presented Joseph Norkiewicz, Jr., his Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal yesterday. Norkiewicz served with the Navy back in 1958 during Operation Blue Bat, a peacekeeping mission in Beirut, Lebanon. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.